Yo guys, it's KQ, we're back in the video and today we're showing you what you've just seen on screen. So make sure to drop a like and subscribe, so let's get into it. Alright, so the first thing you want to do is make a new project or go in the project that you're in. I'm just going to make a new sequence. Alright, now I'm starting blank. So first thing you're going to do is drag in your song. I'm just going to zoom in and cut to where it should start. I'm just going to start it around here. I'm just going to drag it back, put it on my last layer. I'm just going to get this clip, this one right here. So I've got the clip I want, so I'm just going to drag it onto my timeline. Then I'm just going to sync it up, drag this back, and then we're left with this. Alright, so the first thing you want to do is have the go to file, import presets, find where you saved all the presets, and import it into Premiere Pro. And then you're going to go to Kiki's editing presets, free presets, tutorials, and it's right here, KQ's EXE one and tutorial. So what you want to do first is add the velocity. Don't do what it says here because it's kind of messed up. All you want to do is select all the keyframes, zoom in a bit, actually zoom out, drag them over, and then you want to go on your timeline, put this one to exactly where the marker is on the kill, so just like that. And then put this middle keyframe right here, there's like two keyframes next to it, just put that middle keyframe there and just play it back just a clean velocity. And then what you want to do now is nest this, so you can either right click and go to nest, and then I'm just going to call this clip. And then now you have the clip. But now, as you can see, it's not long enough until this second beat. So what we're gonna do is go in here, we're gonna remove the velocity, and you're gonna apply an adjustment layer. So go up here, adjustment layer. I have one right here. And you're just gonna put it on the end of this. And then you wanna go back to your edit and then apply the velocity on this adjustment layer. I mean, not the adjustment layer, on the nest. And then go to where the beat is and just want to put this in the center, just like that. And then you're gonna nest it again, and I'm just gonna call this sequence 5 because why not. And then now you can drag this out as well, and then I'm just gonna drag this. Oh, went in the wrong comp. Now I can drag this out to here. So now what we're gonna do after we've done that, we're just gonna split where we get the kill, so right there. And then now what we want to do is split where the beat, the little clap is. So I have it marked there, and then what we're going to do is add EXE 1 in impact. And it's going to add all these effects. If your PC is a bit slow, then it might take a little bit longer. And then what we're going to do now is apply EXE under ident effects. And it's just going to look like that. Now what we want to do is apply the ident. So here you have, I already have an ident here that I made for a client. So if you want an ident like this, just DM me on Twitter and it's gonna be like £12 or something. And so yeah, so you wanna put the ident, make the beat, so where it like starts going all together. You wanna put a marker here and line it up. And then for this song, there's not like any other beats, so it's fine. We're just gonna cut it off here. I'm just gonna find where it starts. The ident comes in, so just cut it off because it's just faster for rendering. So here. Now that looks clean. So once you've done that, you just want to apply a transition. So I'm just gonna nest these three together. Click and nest, and then you're gonna get another clip. I'm gonna use this one, scale it down. So now there's two ways you can do this. So EXE uses a transition pack called Handley Seamless Transitions. You can find like a download for it somewhere on the internet. I'm not gonna provide it on this video. So you can either use those or you can use already made presets that you have. I'm just gonna use Handley Seamless for now. Alright, so once you applied your transition, now you can move on to the second clip. So I'm just gonna cut here. I'm gonna add the same velocity as last time. So go here, 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 and velocity. And then go to where you get the kill. So that's right here. And then apply it the same way. So just like that. And then just nest it. Cut and kill. And now you want to add KQEXE Blur Glow Impact. And that's just gonna make the screen put blur impact that XN kind of uses. So I'm just gonna render this out quickly and then show you the preview. Alright, so now I'm done rendering, and this is what it looks like. Now you're a pro EXE 1N style editor. So if you do use these presets, make sure to drop a like and subscribe to the channel, as it helps so much. Make sure to follow my Twitter and Instagram, link in the description down below. I'm going to be streaming a lot more. I might stream on YouTube, might stream on Twitch, so follow my Twitch as well. And yeah, that's basically it. Thank you so much for watching. Have a great day or night whenever you're watching this, and goodbye.